The United Kingdom and Ireland, December 9th, 2025. Severe storm. Bram swept across the United Kingdom and Ireland with winds reaching 90 miles per hour, bringing torrential rain, widespread flooding, and nationwide transport disruption. On Tuesday, December 9th, 2025, Winter Storm Bram struck the United Kingdom and Ireland with powerful winds and heavy rainfall, creating one of the most chaotic days in years for transport systems, infrastructure, and daily life. Roads, railways, flights, and ferry services were all disrupted, with multiple flights diverted, ferry services suspended, and numerous train journeys canceled or severely delayed. According to the United Kingdom Met Office, Bram delivered exceptional rainfall, triggering widespread flooding across many regions. By Tuesday evening, the United Kingdom recorded more than 300 flood warnings or alerts. Rainfall levels reached extreme highs, especially in South Wales and Southwest England. White Barrow on Dartmoor reported 4.4 inches of rain in 24 hours, while nearby Princetown recorded about 3.1 inches, nearly one-sixth of the area's average December rainfall. Treherbert in South Wales also recorded 3.3 inches in a single day. In North Wales, wind gusts reached up to 83 miles per hour at Capel Curig and Aberdaron. Record rainfall left numerous vehicles stranded in rising floodwaters. In Hampshire, a driver narrowly escaped after her car was swept about 130 feet by fast-moving water. Local residents managed to pull her to safety. In Dorset, four people were rescued after multiple cars became trapped on a flooded road. In Cornwall, emergency crews responded to several similar incidents. In Devon, firefighters rescued two people from the roof of their car after it was submerged in floodwaters in the village of Tagengrace. Major roads faced severe congestion, with several crossings over the River Severn between southwest England and South Wales temporarily closed due to fears that lighting columns might collapse. The Prince of Wales Bridge was reduced to one lane in each direction for safety. Part of the M66 motorway in Greater Manchester was shut after a multi-vehicle collision during flooding. At the same time, the M48 Severn Bridge was also closed temporarily due to strong winds. Power systems across the United Kingdom and Ireland were heavily affected by Storm Bram. Around 25,000 homes, farms, and businesses in the Republic of Ireland lost power on Tuesday evening. In England and Wales, National Grid reported more than 3,000 households without electricity, including about 1,200 in the West Midlands and 600 in the Southwest. An amber weather warning, the second highest level, remained in effect for Scotland until 3 a.m. Wednesday. The United Kingdom Met Office reported gusts of 70 to 80 miles per hour over the Highlands, Eilean Siar, Argyll and Bute, and parts of Strathclyde, with some areas seeing winds above 90 miles per hour. Authorities advised residents to limit travel, especially at night, and prepare emergency kits with warm clothing, water, food, phone chargers, blankets, and flashlights. homeowners were urged to secure outdoor items and lock windows and doors to reduce wind damage. Across the United Kingdom, as of Tuesday evening, there were 37 flood warnings and 148 flood alerts in England, 20 warnings and 48 alerts in Wales, and 33 warnings and 15 alerts in Scotland. These numbers were expected to rise overnight into Wednesday as heavy rainfall continued in many regions. Storm Bram caused severe disruption to air travel. Belfast City Airport was among the hardest hit, with 27 flights canceled due to shifting winds. A British Airways flight from Heathrow spent more than 2 hours and 15 minutes in the air without landing. After multiple attempts, the plane returned to Heathrow. Another flight, an Aer Lingus regional service from Manchester, managed to land only after circling over the Irish Sea for nearly an hour and a half, failing one approach, and finally touching down after 2 hours and 30 minutes, despite the journey usually taking just 45 minutes for the 171-mile route. In Glasgow, passengers faced an afternoon and evening of uncertainty as strong winds forced multiple flight diversions. Flights from Krakow, Alicante, and Lanzarote were rerouted to Manchester. 3 flights from London to Glasgow were also affected. 2 diverted to Newcastle, and 1 British Airways flight returned to its origin. Dublin Airport reported 91 cancelled flights and around 10 diversions due to high winds. In Manchester, the airport temporarily closed, causing chaotic queues and dozens of cancellations, mostly Aer Lingus flights to Dublin or Belfast. Alongside air travel disruption, ferry operations across the Irish Sea were nearly paralyzed. All major operators canceled daytime sailings connecting Ireland, Northern Ireland, Wales, and Scotland. In the Western Isles, all Caledonian MacBrayne ferry routes were disrupted, with many suspended for the entire day due to dangerous sea conditions. Forecasts indicated the disruption would continue into Wednesday morning, as the amber wind warning remained in effect for northwest Scotland and Northern Ireland. Rail transport also faced major challenges, with wind speeds reaching 90 miles per hour, forcing operators to reduce speeds or suspend service. The West Coast Main Line, the crucial rail route linking London Euston with the West Midlands, northwest England, North Wales, and southern Scotland, ran at significantly reduced capacity due to safety-related speed limits. Avanti West Coast warned passengers that journeys would take longer than usual and that disruptions were likely to continue for hours. In Scotland, the routes between Inverness and Kyle of Lochalsh and between Fort William and Mallaig were completely shut due to wind gusts reaching 90 miles per hour. ScotRail announced that tickets would be valid until December 11th to ease travel pressure during the severe weather. Several other rail lines were expected to reopen late on Wednesday morning as engineers assessed infrastructure damage after the storm.
Jesus.
The United Kingdom Met Office reported that Storm Bram would gradually weaken on Wednesday, though strong winds and scattered showers could continue to cause disruptions through the weekend. Meanwhile, authorities continued inspecting infrastructure, clearing debris, and ensuring safety before restoring full service. Tuesday's events marked one of the most severe early winter weather episodes the United Kingdom has experienced in recent years.